Now, if we do in vitro fertilization, we all know that the pregnancy rate is related to the number of eggs that are obtained in a stimulation cycle. Now, you could stimulate mildly and get a small number of eggs, but I mean in a standard conventional stimulation cycle, it's very clear that the pregnancy rate is related to the number of eggs. And you can see from this graph, the number of eggs you retrieve in a IVF cycle is related to your antral follicle count. So I'll just show this quick little movie that will give you an idea of just exactly how we can count antral follicles with ultrasound and determine from that just how fertile you are, or that is where you are right now on your biological clock.
This is Michelle's right ovary, and the black circles are the follicles on her ovary.
The antral follicles are fluid-filled areas where eggs can grow and mature. You can't see eggs with the naked eye. So radiology technician Mary Williams will count the number of antral follicles, those black circles.
Like this one, that one, that one.
That number is directly proportional to the total number of eggs that you have left in your ovaries. Well, by putting it into that mathematical curve, we can tell them when they're likely to become infertile, whether it's in 5 years or 10 years or 1 year.
10, 11. 12. I would say she has 12 antral follicles.
That's 12 on the right ovary, now to the left.
And I'll go through and count the antral follicles on this ovary. So 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now, if you look at this table from Dr. Malcolm Faddy's paper in 2003, which was the real landmark paper on this, you can actually count, by looking at the count of the antral follicles on the left, and he talks about it being median number of years to last child. What that really boils down to is how many years of fertility you're likely to have left. Now, it's not a guarantee. Some women will be infertile for other reasons when they've got a lot of antral follicles and lose their infertility earlier. But this is the average number of years in which you have a chance of getting pregnant. So this is the antral follicle count per ovary. And you can see that if you have an antral follicle count of 20 per ovary, or 40 antral follicle counts, you probably have 15 more years of fertility left, and you'll probably go through menopause in about 24 years. On the other hand, if you're down to 10 per ovary, let's say you have an antral follicle count of 20, you may only have 4 years of infertility left, and you're likely to go through menopause about 13 years later. Now, once you get down to where you only have 5 antral follicles per ovary, which is a total count of 10, you're very, very unlikely to still be fertile. Now, you may be able to get pregnant with IVF, but you're unlikely to be fertile. And, in fact, you're likely to go through menopause in about 7 or 8 years once your count is down that low. So, these are just averages. But it shows you some basic guidelines you can go by. So if you're 25 and you have an antral follicle count of 40, don't worry. But if you're 25 and you have an antral follicle count of 10, then you ought to do something, and that's what we're going to tell you about. Now, here is just a picture that of a woman undergoing stimulation for IVF so that we can retrieve multiple eggs. And we're all used to this. All doctors have seen this pretty regularly. And you can see these follicles that are all with mature eggs in them. So maybe we can get 5 to 10 or 15 eggs in a stimulation cycle. But that's not what we're talking about with antral follicles. With antral follicles, we're talking about a resting ovary, where we have these little tiny follicles that are 2 to 5 millimeters in size, and they are exactly proportional to the number of eggs every day that leave the resting pool, and they are therefore definitely proportional to your total egg count. And they're predictive of how good your result will be with IVF, and they're predictive about how many years of infertility, or rather fertility, you have left before you become infertile. Not a guarantee, but it's a very, very good guideline. And here you can see, I'm just showing you a number of views of ultrasounds where we're looking at, normally these little tiny follicles are disregarded. No one pays attention to them. They're not in the reading. But when you do the standard ultrasound, if the radiology tech will just count these little holes, so to speak, it looks like Swiss cheese, then they'll be able to figure for you just where you are in your biologic clock and how worried you should be. I'm just running through a few of them so you get an idea. In summary, there are two things that affect your advancing infertility or your decreasing fertility as you get older. It's all related to your eggs. First is the number of eggs you have, and second is the quality of the eggs. If you have a large number of eggs, you're likelier to have good quality eggs at whatever age. However, there is no question that even with a large number of eggs, your age does have an independent effect on egg quality. So I'm not saying that if you have an high antral follicle count and you're 40 years old, that you should just rest easy and not worry about trying to have children for another 5 years. Now, that would be a real mistake. What I'm saying is, if you're 25 and have an antral follicle count of 10 or even 15, you should do something about it. Or if you're 38 or 40 and have a high antral follicle count, you shouldn't delay childbearing or freezing your eggs, but on the other hand, at least you know you've got a good prognosis.